Hey, want some sunscreen? This stuff is really strong. SPF 4000 or something.
Nah, I don't need it. I've heard the ozone in the atmosphere protects me from the sun's harmful rays.
Really? Is that true? Is the ozone a good thing? I've always heard that it was bad. And what is ozone anyways?
Great questions. Ozone is important, and it can be good or bad depending on where it is. Ozone is a gas made up of three oxygen atoms bonded together that occurs in the Earth's atmosphere. In the troposphere, where we live and where airplanes fly, small amounts of ozone are produced naturally by plants and lightning. A larger amount is put there by human activities like factory and car emissions, which contributes to air pollution.
Ozone in the troposphere isn't a good thing.
But in the stratosphere, the layer above the troposphere, ozone is a good thing. It protects us from much of the sun's harmful ultraviolet radiation.
Ozone helps to block most UV radiation coming from the sun. That's because instead of the radiation making it all the way to the Earth's surface, the radiation is absorbed by ozone and oxygen molecules. This radiation provides the energy needed for a series of reactions to occur. These reactions destroy and create ozone all the time. In the stratosphere, UV radiation breaks up oxygen molecules into free oxygen atoms. These free atoms bond with other oxygen molecules to form ozone. UV radiation is also absorbed by ozone molecules. This breaks ozone apart into oxygen molecules and single, very reactive oxygen atoms. This system is in balance, or equilibrium, because both the destruction and creation of ozone happen at the same rate.
So ozone always stays the same? What about this ozone hole I've heard of?
Right, the hole. The stratosphere might seem far away from us, but it isn't immune to human impacts. In the 1970s, scientists who had been monitoring the amount of ozone in the stratosphere over Antarctica since the 1950s noticed that it was the lowest they'd ever seen. In the 1920s, humans started using gases called chlorofluorocarbons, or CFCs, in refrigerators, air conditioners, and later in aerosol sprays. Over time, these CFC gases made their way up through the atmosphere into the stratosphere. In the stratosphere, UV radiation strikes CFC molecules, which causes them to release a free chlorine atom.
A chlorine atom can react with ozone, and it converts the ozone into O2 and a ClO molecule. And then a ClO molecule can react with an oxygen atom, and that forms O2, but the chlorine atoms reform again. And then the ClO plus O creates the chlorine atom again and another O2 molecule. So the net is you've taken ozone and you've converted it into two molecules of O2. So ozone goes to a regular oxygen molecule, right? But the chlorine atom is still there. And that's how it can act like a little Pac-Man and go on and eat up 100,000 ozone molecules. So that's a catalytic process.
Oh, that's what the ozone hole is.
It's not so much a hole as a thinning in the ozone layer, but that's still a problem. But there is good news. After noticing the low levels of ozone, in 1987, an international treaty called the Montreal Protocol was put into place to ban CFCs. Eventually, all 197 countries in the United Nations joined the ban. And it's been successful. Since 1993, CFC levels in the atmosphere have decreased significantly.
That's great news for the ozone layer and for us. The U.S. Environmental Protection Agency says that the Montreal Protocol can help prevent millions of cases of deadly skin cancer from occurring in the future. But you should still wear sunscreen because even a healthy ozone layer doesn't block all of the sun's harmful UV radiation.
Oh, okay. Hey, if every country in the world came together to solve the thinning of the ozone problem, what global problems could we solve if we just put our heads together?